I'm going to end up like her, aren't I, Doctor?
I've no idea. I really don't know what's wrong with you. But if what I suspect is true, then there's no reason why you should, when a simple operation could give you a perfectly normal life. I must be going.
Doctor.
Yes, Judy?
I will have the tests.
Hi, Annie. What have you been up to, eh?
I wonder why older men always go after younger women.
Look, if you arrive at the hotel, Fletcher will take one look inside the package and it's game, set and match for you. I've got to make sure he's not there.
How?
That's my problem. Yours is to deliver the parcel.
Okay. I'll see you later.
Travelling.
Never heard of it.
What's it to do with spirits, I think?
Don't go filling your head with that crap.
Yeah, some idiots reckon they can leave their bodies and travel all over the place.
Yeah, they reckon they can go wherever they like.
I wouldn't get too excited if I were you. I think you're here for the duration.
Do you reckon that's what Ken's play's about?
Oh, it's hard to get peace and quiet in here. Shut up, will you, door?
Well, this is about fairies, and that's what Ken was saying, isn't it?
All right. I'll say this just once. So listen, I'm not interested in anything Ken Pierce says or does. And as to that rubbish you had us doing, well, I'm not interested in that either. I've had it.
Why don't you leave that for Sally to do in the morning?
Well, I may as well do it. Get out of the way.
We've got enough to do without doing her work. I wouldn't do it.
Well, I would. I'm not going to get much done sitting around talking to you all night, am I? So if you don't mind.
Not at all. Have a pleasant night.
Hello?
Leela, it's Jim. Hello, you still there?
Yes. I just thought... Well, it doesn't matter. What do you want?
Well, I'm on night duty. I just thought I'd ring, see how the boys are.
Oh, that was very nice of you, Jim. You shouldn't have bothered.
Look, Leela, I wonder if we could make an exception just this once and not go for the throat, OK? Just tell me how the boys are and I'll let you get back to whatever you're doing.
That's very funny. What I'm doing is scrubbing the paint off the doors. Oh, that's right. You didn't know, did you? You're too busy looking after your damn prison and the ex-inmates.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the person who broke in here and painted Hello Leela over the walls.
For God's sake, why didn't you tell me?
Oh, now it's my fault, is it?
Look, don't play the martyr. Did he hurt anyone? Are the boys okay?
Oh, we're fine. We didn't even see him.
Look, I can't talk now. I'll ring you back later, okay?
If you can spare the time.
Look, I suppose you did call the... Can I help you, Mrs. Davidson?
No, I'm just on my way home. Mr. Fletcher, it's no good pretending I didn't hear that. Is everything all right? Is there anything I can do?
There's nothing that I can't handle, Mrs. Davidson. See you in the morning.
Are you feeling all right?
Of course I am.
You're not worried?
Well, why should I be? It's only a few simple tests, that's all.
Oh, I'm glad you're having those tests, Jude. They're pretty smart, those doctors. And once they know what's wrong with you, they'll fix you up in no time. Just like Lizzie.
That old fraud. You don't think she fooled me, do you? Anyway, it was probably for the best. Made me think, didn't it? Made me think what a
thick head I've been.
It was worth it just to see the look on Bee's face when old Lizzie folded up.
I thought the old bat was going to die herself.
Don't talk about dying, Jude. Don't even joke about it.
Now listen to me. When I leave here, I'm walking out, right? Nothing's going to happen to your old Jude.
I'm sorry to call in so early, but I was on my way to Wentworth and I realised...
Oh, that's all right. Please, sit down.
Thank you.
Would you like a cup of tea? I'm going to have one.
I'd love one, but I think I'd better speak to Mr. Fletcher and then get off to work.
Oh, isn't he at the hotel?
Hotel?
Well, Jim doesn't live here anymore, Mrs. Davidson. We're separated.
Oh, I had no idea. I am sorry. I would never have bothered you.
Oh, don't worry. I'm only sorry that we haven't got a man in the house to worry about this prowler.
You mean someone broke in and did that?
Yeah, and we had a brick through the window the other night.
But that's dreadful. What did the police have to say? Surely Jim would want to do
whatever Jim wants or doesn't want has got nothing to do with Wentworth, Mrs. Davidson.
I'm sorry. I think I'd better leave now and talk to you later.
I'll show you out, Mrs. Davidson.
Thank you.
There was no need for that, Jim.
No need? I come straight home from work to find out how my family is and I find
my... Oh, so you're a family man now, are you?
I just want to know whether you and the kids are all right.
We're all right. No thanks to you. The police will catch this maniac, so why don't you just vanish?
Look, Leela, I know you must feel. But I want to see the kids again. I do have that right, you know.
Yes, you do have that right. Look, if you want to see the kids, why don't you just take them out for the day? Leave me alone.
There's nothing I'd like better than to take the kids out for the day. I've just got home from work. I'm due back there again later this afternoon. I've got to rest sometime, you know.
Well, that's typical.
What are you talking about?
I'm fed up, that's all, with you and the whole damn mess. Your wife and children have been terrorised and threatened and you just worry about that bloody prison.
It's not like that at all and you know it. I try to spend as much time
all
as I
know is your friends seem more important than your family. You seem to care what happens to them, but you don't seem to care what happens...
Oh, come on, Pat, you've got a face as long as a wet weekend. Give us a smile for God's sake.
Oh, I'm all right. I just don't feel like smiling, that's all.
What you need's a good man, Pat. It does wonders for you. I mean, look at Bee over there. It's done wonders for her.
You shut your mouth, Gilmour. And what would you know about a man?
Oh, no, we have got our knickers in a knot. Maybe we need to put a little drama back into our lives.
Any more smart-ass comments out of you and I'll ram those teeth of yours right down your throat. And that goes for the rest of you. Do you hear? I don't want any more cracks about the drama group. Got it?
I don't know what you're on about. All I
got it?
I'm glad we're not doing any more plays anyway. All them there's, thou's and this's and tis's.
O'Connell, outside. Your solicitor's here to see you.
Good luck, Pat.
Well, come on, O'Connell, move. The rest of you can get back to work.
How's your little dog settling in, Miss Bennett?
It's none of your concern, Birdsworth. Back to work.
Vinegar tit sure doesn't improve with age, does she? I wonder why Pat's seeing her solicitor.
About her appeal, of course. It's tomorrow.
Yeah? Wonder how she'll go.
She's been real worried about it, but I reckon she's got a fair chance.
Since when did fairness come into it?
Hello, Pat.
Miss Saunders.
Thank you, Miss Bennett.
Has something gone wrong?
Wrong?
With the appeal.
Oh, no. No, I just want to go through the procedure again before we go to court tomorrow. And the way you handle yourself is going to be very important. I'm sorry, sit down. Now then, as you know, the appeal is being heard before a bench of the Supreme Court. Now, there'll be three judges. One will argue in favour of your case and one against it.
Sounds as if they've already made up their minds.
No, no, that's just normal procedure. I mean, no new evidence can be produced. It's a legal argument. Was your trial influenced by the publicity surrounding it or wasn't it? And we have to prove that it was.
I know all that. It's not very likely, is it?
It's possible. Pat, as I said before,
Your behaviour in court tomorrow is going to be vital to your case. Now, you go in with that attitude and we haven't got a hope. Well, look, if you don't want to think of yourself, shouldn't you think of your children? I mean, you've got to give them a chance.
Maybe they've got more chance in the home.
Get away. Yeah, all right, I'm coming.
Mr. Fletcher?
Yeah.
I'm Detective Parsons, Sergeant Jennings.
Yeah, come in.
Thank you.
Well, I can't say I'm pleased to see you blokes. I just finished a double shift and I'm due back at Wentworth later this afternoon.
Well, this shouldn't take up too much of your time, Mr. Fletcher. Just making a few inquiries about the break-in reported by your wife.
Yeah, I thought you might.
Now, this painted message, "Hello, Leela," pretty innocuous, isn't it? I mean, there's no threat, is there?
Well, I would have thought it was threatening enough. Someone breaks into your house, somebody who obviously knows you.
And my thoughts exactly. Obviously, you and your wife aren't living together at the moment. May I ask whose choice that was?
No, you damn well may not. You're not suggesting I had something to do with this, do you?
It's a possibility.
Yeah.
However, your wife thought it was more likely to be a Michael Simpson. You know this Simpson, Mr. Fletcher?
Yeah, vaguely.
How did you meet him?
Well, I helped his wife when she was on remand at Wentworth.
Was?
She's out on bail now.
Should be grateful.
Yeah, well, she didn't go back to him. She's staying at a halfway house.
Letter for you. For me? I wonder who... It's a secret admirer. Oh, wish I had one. It's so bloody boring in here sometimes. What's the matter? Gee, that's terrible. Who'd do a thing like that?
Oh, my bloody husband, who else?
Your husband? You sure?
Well, I'm pretty sure it's petty enough.
Look, you want to do what Mum used to do when she was having trouble with the old man? She took out a court order against him. You couldn't worry her at all. Not without going to the nick.
Ah, maybe if I just ignore him, he'll get tired of it.
Pigs might fly.
Come in.
Busy?
Ah, never too busy for one of our leading barristers, especially one who's handling a case of mine. What can I do for you?
Well, with all that build-up, you could ask me for my autograph.
Sit down.
Thanks.
Well, then, how's Pat O'Connell's case looking?
That's what I wanted to see you about.
We got problems?
On the legal argument, no problem. No, I think I've got a pretty good case.
Great.
However, other things can sway the court. Now, I can present the legal argument, but the way Pat handles herself is going to be far more important than anything I have to say.
In other words, why should they believe you if she doesn't? Is that what you mean?
Exactly. Mm. And at the moment, Pat is very depressed.
Well, what can I do?
Paul, I think she should see her children.
No.
If she could just go to the home, see how upset they are. Why little Andrew ran away, I'm sure she'd go into court with a far more positive attitude.
Look, you don't have to convince me, but you know all the red tape I'd have to go through. She's due in court tomorrow. There's no way in the world I'd get her out of here before then.
Well, could they come here then?
I could try, but the chances are pretty slim.
Not as slim as my chances in court tomorrow if Pat doesn't change her attitude.
Is that you, Louise? Who's there? Louise?
Oh. Sorry, love. I didn't mean to frighten you. I thought I'd come in through the back door. I thought it might be safer.
You look awful. You can sit down and make you some coffee.
But,
have you had anything to eat?
No. Carolyn, what are we going to do? I'm fed up with sneaking in through back doors, only meeting at night.
What's wrong, love? Something happened.
I rang Leela last night.
Someone broke into the house, painted a message across the back of the doors. No one was hurt, but that's not the point. They could have been.
Same message?
Who's doing it? That's what I'd like to know. It can't be Jeff Butler. Meg saw him at the restaurant the night the brick was thrown through our window.
Well, I've only met him once. Why on earth would
he... Because he's mad. Because he hates my guts. That's not his style. He's punch mad.
It has to be Michael.
That gutless wonder. He wouldn't have the nerve. He's getting popular, though. Even Lila thought it might be him.
Well, she didn't tell the police about him, did she?
Hmm?
Well, if she did, they'll find out about us. You'll lose your job.
I don't care. I just don't care anymore. It's not worth it. All I want is for us to be happy.
Whoops. Sorry. It's no good, is it? Maybe we should stop seeing each other until all this blows over.
Did I ever tell you about the time I played King of the Fairies and I had these little wings stuck right out of the middle of me back?
Yes, you did, Lizzie, so shut up.
I was only telling Pat about the time
Lizzie!
I...
Lizzie!
Oh, isn't that terrific? Just because your nose is out of joint, we all have to miss out on the drama class.
You've already been warned.
The person's entitled to an opinion.
Right, that does it.
Come on, Pat. You've got visitors.
But I'm not expecting anybody. Who is it?
You'll find out.
Can I go to the loo, Mrs. Jackson?
All right, then, but hurry up.
Why aren't you taking me to the interview room, Mrs. Jackson?
I don't think your visitors would enjoy that, Pat.
Hello, darling. Hello, sweetheart. How are you?
Okay.
Well, you've got Miss Saunders to thank for this. She thought that you might like to see Emma and Andrew before your hearing tomorrow.
Thank you. Come on, let's go over there and sit down.
Don't see many things in here to make you happy, do you?
No, you don't.
Grandma came to visit us.
Well, that's wonderful, darling.
Why can't we go and stay with Grandma? I hate the place we're in.
Well, Grandma's still very sick, sweetheart. I know if she could look after you and Emma, she'd have you there in a flash.
Well, I'm not staying in the home anymore. I hate it. It's not fair.
I know, darling.
It's terrible, Mum.
Don't worry, sweetheart. A lot of people are working very hard to make sure we'll all be together.
Soon, Mum.
I hope so, darling. I hope so.
Must be nice to have kids.
Yeah, Pat hasn't had much fun out of hers, though.
No. Yeah, I guess I'm better off the way I am, whatever happens.
You still worried about going to hospital?
Yeah. You won't say anything to Sharon, will you?
No, of course not.
Come on, you two, inside. You heard the bell.
Oh, hi,
B.
What's the buzz?
Oh, the usual. Nothing. Except Pat's got a visitor.
Oh, yeah. It's her kids. I saw him in the garden when I was knocking off.
Oh, good. That'll buck her up, if anything will.
Yeah.
See you, Lizzie.
How are you, love?
Well, I'm a lot better than you are if your little party trick's anything to go by.
Party trick? Oh, that. Oh, I did that for your sake, love.
Yeah, I know. And you'll be glad to know I've decided to have the tests after all.
Good on you. That's one of the perks you can have when you've got a weak heart. Sometimes you can get on the outside.
Well, if that's how you get on the outside, I think I'd rather stay inside. Hiya.
I'll shuffle along and I'll see you later.
See you later, Liz. Well, what's the matter?
Bloody bee, of course.
Well, that's nothing new.
She's like a bear with a sore head. Ever since she saw Ken with that young thing, you can't even think about the drama group, let alone say anything.
And since when have you been interested in the drama group?
It's bugger all else going on.
Okay. Tell me what happened with Bee.
The usual thing. She's coming to heavy with everybody.
Yes, well, that's nothing new. I mean, have you been needling her or something?
Oh, that's great, that is. I even get blamed when she plays the heavy.
No.
Don't you worry about me, Jude. Just kick me as you go past.
You feeling better?
Yes. They've grown, haven't they? Especially Andrew.
Yes.
But he still needs his mum.
Well, the children are on their way back to the home, but not for long, we hope.
No. I know I've got to go through with it now. Do whatever I can so we can all be together again.
Good.
Mr. Reid, if I do win the appeal, how long will it be before the parole board lets me out of here?
Oh, I'm not too sure, Pat, but I'll lodge your application straight away.
What if I don't win the appeal?
We'll worry about that if and when it happens, shall we?
Are we all met? Pat. And here's a marvellous convenient place for our rehearsal. This green plot shall be our stage. This horse... Oh, bugger this. When this goose learns how to write, then I'll learn how to act. I don't know why that you took me into it. It's rubbish.
Oh, come on, be a sport.
No bloody way. Oh. Phil, will you play Quince?
Oh, geez, do I have to?
Oh, come on, Phil.
She doesn't have to. She doesn't want to.
Oh, I can't say this. It's stupid. What sayest thou, bully bottom? Rather watch telly.
Oh, Pat, will you play Quince?
Okay, Doreen.
Oh, yeah, Pat, you're first.
Oh, come on, give her a go.
How was it, love? Are the kids glad to see you?
Oh, yes. Oh, look, they hate it where they are. Mm. Mr. Reid arranged for them to come here and see me. He really went to a lot of trouble.
Oh, it's nice to know you've got friends in high places. All set for tomorrow?
I hope so. I'll tell you what, if we lose, it won't be for want of trying.
Well, don't let me interrupt. I just popped in to see how the play reading's going.
I'm being Quince, Mr. Reid.
Congratulations. B, what part are you playing?
Nothing. I don't go in for this these and thous crap.
Oh, we'll get a car soon enough. Don't worry.
Oh, you're a devil for punishment. Well, it doesn't pay to be nice to some people.
Very tired, Vera.
That's his problem. He shouldn't be rude to everyone.
Look, he's a worried man. He looks terrible. What are you doing here at this time? Thought you'd be home walking your dog.
Oh, I don't have to worry about that anymore.
Well, don't tell me she's run away.
No, I just finally found her owner, that's all.
Oh, that's a pity. She was a nice little thing.
It was only a dog.
Well, what's wrong with Jimmy? Just about bit my head off out there.
You can't be trusted, Lizzie. And while I'm at it, how's the comic?
Real good.
What comic?
You bloody know what comic. You pitched that too, didn't you?
All right, Sheila, keep it down.
I'm warning you, Lizzie. First thing in the morning, I want the comic and the biscuits back.
Quiet!
You might have a bit of trouble with the biggies.
Will you two keep it down, or do you want to spend some time in the pound?
You wouldn't speak to Caroline Simpson like that.
Morning.
Morning, Mr. Reid.
Do you have a minute? I'd like to talk to you about the Pat O'Connell case. The hearing's on this afternoon.
Of course. What are her chances?
Well, her barrister seems fairly confident.
Good.
Yeah, now, as I understand it, even if the appeal is successful, she would still have 6 months of her original sentence to serve.
That is correct.
Well, I was wondering if you couldn't talk to the parole board. You know, wouldn't hurt to get in early, would it?
Well, that's a good idea. I'll see what I can do. Is that all?
No, there was one other problem. The drama group, it seems as though it's off again.
Why, I thought we had all that sorted out.
Even so did I, but the women have lost interest. And believe me, I'm becoming quite accustomed to one-day wonders around here.
Well, there must be some reason for this.
If there is, the women won't tell me.
We'll see what you can find out, would you, Mr. Reid?
Yeah, I'll do my best.
Before you go, have you noticed Jim Fletcher's behaviour lately?
He has been a little bit touchy lately. Why?
Nothing really. It's just that I'm a bit worried about him, that's all. He seems to be loading too much work on himself. Has he confided in you about any problem he might have? Well, I wouldn't ask normally, but I can't ignore it when it affects his work.
Jim does tend to keep himself to himself, you know.
Yes. Well, see what you can find out about the drama group, won't you?
I'll let you know.
This is what I'll plant the Bob Hope in. I'll plenty of drugs, mate. I tell you what, I'll load Mr. High and bloody mighty Fletcher down so heavy, he'll sink without trace.
When?
Soon enough. You expecting anyone?
Could be anybody.
I'm not here.
Well, actually, I was just on my way to work.
This won't keep you too long, Mr. Simpson. Just wondering whether you knew a Leela Fletcher.
No.
She's married to an officer at Wentworth Detention Centre, Jim Fletcher.
Ah, well, I've met him, but I don't know his wife. I didn't even know her name.
I see. Do you have any record of your whereabouts during the past week?
Well, I've got an office diary that's pretty detailed.
Mind if I have a look at it?
No, of course not.
Thank you. When was the last time you visited the Fletcher house?
I've never been to the Fletcher house.
What about where your wife's staying?
What do you mean?
What I mean, Mr. Simpson, is have you been trying to frighten her? Maybe get her to come back home?
What makes you think I want her home?
Well, she's your wife.
Yes, but you know what she did. She murdered her father.
That has not been proved.
No, but I know her. Anyway, we weren't even living together before she was arrested.
I see. Well, I think that's about everything. Do you mind if we keep this just for the time being?
Not at all.
Purely routine. Thank you. Oh, one other point. If you do decide to visit your wife in the immediate future, you will let us know, won't you? It could save some embarrassment.
Have you been to see Caroline?
Of course not.
Then what did he mean by that last remark?
How should I know? Look, mate, if you don't believe me, let's just call the whole thing quits. You can pay me for the time I've wasted and forget all about Jim Fletcher. It's no skin off my nose that he's been having it off with your wife.
I'm sorry. I suppose the police must have shaken me up a bit.
You want to go ahead? Good boy. Well, now, you better just run along to work, eh? We can't have you being late, can we?
You want to see me?
Yes, come in, B. Sit down.
I'd rather stand.
Okay, suit yourself. I want to know why the women have lost interest in this drama project. Now, come on, B, there has to be a reason. Is it the choice of plays? Are they too difficult for you? Or is it Ken Pierce? Don't you like him?
Nothing to do with me. Just because I've lost interest doesn't mean the others can't carry on without me.
Look, B, you have given this project the thumbs down. You know it, and I know it.
Oh, yeah? Now, where'd you get an idea like that?
It wasn't too damn difficult to work out, I can tell you. B, I'm going to get to the bottom of this because I am sick and tired of you mucking up every project we try here.
Can I go now?
Go.
How do I look? Oh, if I was a bloke, I'd go for you. Good, this place must be kitten to me.
Oh, geez, you look real nice, Pat. Clothes make a real difference, don't they?
Yep. You'll melt their hearts. Don't forget to show a bit of leg.
Oh, that'd really do me a lot of good.
Oh, don't you worry, love. You'll only be coming back here to say goodbye.
I hope so. The kids are really depending on it.
Oh, cut it out. You're making me nervous.
Oh, Bee.
Good luck, love. Don't let those bastards get you down. Remember, we're gonna beat them, okay?
Right.
Looks like we're gonna have to advertise for a new cellmate.
Wentworth Detention Centre, Officer Bennett speaking.
Could I speak to the Deputy Governor, Jim Fletcher, please?
Mr. Fletcher's in another wing at the moment. Can I take a message?
Ted Rogers is my name. I was hoping to meet Jim for a drink after work. Could you tell me what time he finishes?
Not until tonight. He's working a double shift. Can I get him to call you back?
Oh, no, don't bother. I'll catch up with him tomorrow. Thanks very much for your trouble. Fletcher won't be back till late tonight.
We're doing it tonight.
Tonight, Jim Fletcher gets his.
Things have changed. The police have questioned me about Fletcher's wife.
And you fooled them completely. They don't suspect you. They don't even think you're interested in your wife, let alone in Jim Fletcher. Did they give you a diary back?
Yes.
Well, there you go. You're in the clear, aren't you? And I tell you what, if somebody had pinched my wife and was betting her, I'd want to do more to get rid of him than just pay money.
Well, so do I, but...
But you haven't got the guts.
I've got the guts. Don't you worry about that.
Well, deliver the package. There's no danger. He won't be there.
Have you heard that Vinegar's finally found a friend?
You must be joking. You'd have to be a dog to be friendly with her.
How'd you guess?
I won't stand that sort of talk, Smith.
Oh, I don't know what you're talking about.
You're deliberately impudent to an officer. You can report for cleaning duties after lunch.
Oh!
The rest of you can wipe those grins off your faces. Oh. Do you hear me? All right, if you think it's that funny, you can all report for cleaning duties.
Oh, come on.
Shut up!
Take these women to the dining room, please, Miss Bennett. I want to see you in my office, Mr. Fletcher. No.
All right, you heard the governor. To the dining room. Well, move!
Oh, God, she's just as bad.
I must start by apologising about yesterday, but you must realise I had no idea that you and Leela were separated.
But why were you there?
I had one or two things to discuss with you.
Couldn't you do that in office hours? I mean, Dad, I spend enough time here. You have to follow me home as well.
Exactly. You spend far too much time here. I realise why now, but it's not good enough. It's starting to affect your work.
I told you, I'm as fit as a fiddle.
You are not! That scene I just witnessed was totally unreasonable. And it's not the first time it's happened.
You didn't hear what Smith said about Miss Bennett.
I don't care what she said. You know as well as I do that baiting the officers is the prisoner's favourite pastime. Anyway, Miss Bennett seemed to ignore it.
I don't think she heard it. Besides, it was a matter of judgment.
Your judgment is impaired. Jim, you're tired. I want you to finish your shift now, go home and get some sleep. You need it.
Am I being relieved of my duties?
Of course not. You've worked your shift, you're entitled to go home, which is exactly what you're going to do.
Well, what about my orders on the cleaning duties? I suppose I'm going to lose credibility as well.
I'll see that they are carried out.
But I should be there to supervise it.
It will not be necessary. Jim, I am not asking you. I'm telling you. Go home.
You feeling better, love?
Yeah, a little bit.
Would you like to have a biscuit with your milk?
No, thanks. What's the matter, Mum?
Oh, nothing, dear.
Aren't you going to answer the door?
Oh, of course I am.
Oh, Julie, it's you. Come in.
Just called over to see if everything's all right.
Oh, everything's fine, thanks.
Hello, Matthew. Having a day home from school?
Oh, he hasn't been well.
I expect it's all this Prowler business. I mean, that's why I popped over. You can never be too sure.
Well, I'm taking him to see Jim later on. I think that'll make him happier.
Do you want me to look after Nicholas while you're gone?
Oh, no, thanks. He's coming too. He'd never forgive me if Matthew and I visited Jim without him. They adore each other.
Kids are funny, aren't they?
Afternoon, Mr. Fletcher. Lovely day.
Yeah, email?
No, there's none for you. Anything else we can do for you?
Yes, just make sure I'm not disturbed, will you?
Pardon?
I'm very tired. I'm going to my room to sleep. Can you make sure that I'm not disturbed?
Yeah, righto.
So what went wrong, Doreen?
Wrong? What do you mean?
With the drama group, why have the women lost interest in it? They were all very keen when it first started.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know how it is.
I don't know how it is. I think Bea Smith knows how it is, but she's not saying to me.
Yeah, well, it's not even Bea's fault. It's that Ken Pierce. He's the one to blame.
Ken Pierce wants the drama group.
Yeah, well, he shouldn't go around kissing girls half his age. You should have seen it. It was disgusting.
One of the prisoners?
No, she's waiting outside the gates. Bea saw it. And that was that.
I see. You're saying that Bea fancies Ken? Thank you very much, Doreen. You've been a great help. I think I can handle it from here on.
You wouldn't let on to Bea what I said.
Of course not.
I wouldn't like her to think I lagged on her.
She won't know anything about it. Thank you, Doreen.
Yeah, well, all right.
Thank you very much.
I've spoken to the parole board, Mr. Reid. They will be guided by the verdict of O'Connell's appeal. If it's successful, they won't stand in the way of her parole.
Fine.
Do you have any news about the drama group?
Yes, I think our troubles are over, but I have a bit more work to do yet.
Good.
I was asked to deliver a parcel to Mr. Jim Fletcher. I understand he's still at work, but my instructions were to see the parcel delivered to his room.
Well, Mr. Fletcher is in, sir. Look, he gave strict instructions not to be disturbed.
Oh.
Well, look, I'll take the parcel and see that Mr. Fletcher gets it at the earliest possible moment. All right.
Thanks.
Any message?
No. He knows all about it.
I won't be able to file those just yet, Mrs. Davidson. I'm still trying to work out the roster.
Oh, don't worry, I'll do it.
Look, it's almost impossible to work out this roster. I'm beginning to wish that Mr. Fletcher was here, tired or not.
Well, he was far too run down, Miss Bennett. If none of the officers are willing to do a double shift, I'm quite prepared to do it. Won't be the first time I've carried the keys. Oh, Mr. Pierce, I didn't know you were coming in today.
Paul Reid asked me to come over. I believe there's been some trouble.
Oh, you could say that, but I think it's all sorted out now. If you'd like to sign on, Miss Bennett will escort you to Mr. Reed's office.
Oh, of course. I'll do all this in my tea break. Let's go.
Come in.
Mr. Pierce to see you.
Ah, thank you, Miss Bennett. Ken, good to see you. Miss Bennett, I'd like to see B. Smith in here straight away, please.
I'm too busy.
Please.
Very well.
Very well, I'm too busy. Women.
What's the problem, Paul? You mentioned something about the drama group.
Yes, it's falling apart at the seams.
But why? I thought everything was going okay.
Yes, it was, wasn't it? I think I know what's wrong. Ken, did you meet somebody here after the last session?
No, just my daughter, Debbie.
Yes, well, I thought as much.
What's that got to do with the drama group?
I'm told that you have a secret admirer here. Bea Smith. Obviously, she saw you meeting your daughter, thought that your daughter was somebody else, and she's been trying to put a stop to the drama group ever since. A woman scorned, all that sort of thing.
I see. Yeah.
Anyway, that's why I asked you to come here. I need your help. I know it's a hell of an imposition, but...
Oh, no worries, Paul. I understand.
Good.
You asked to see me?
Yes, B, you know Ken, of course. We wanted to talk about the drama group.
I told you before it had nothing to do with me.
Mm. Yeah, well, there are a couple of people I have to see first. I'll be back in a few minutes.
You haven't left Smith alone with Pierce.
Yeah, well, it's perfectly all right, I can assure you.
It's against regulations.
Look, you can observe them from here, but I want them to be alone. It's very important, I promise.
We'll see about this. I'll have to report it to the governor.
I'm about to do that myself, so you just keep an eye on them and don't interrupt.
What's this I hear about trouble with the drama group?
Oh, well, you know what women are like.
Can it be fixed?
Not by me, it can't. I've got other things to do.
Well, so have I, Bea. You know, I don't see my daughter nearly as much as I should do. Debbie be the first one to tell you that. Do you know she had to meet me here after our last meeting? Because I haven't seen her for days.
Your daughter?
Yeah.
Oh.
So you see, I really don't have much time to waste on groups that aren't interested.
Well, it's probably just a phase. I wouldn't be surprised if they wanted to get back to it already.
That's up to them.
Yeah. I'll have a chat with them and see what they think.
Good.
Of course, the pace is much slower in Queensland, but that's half the charm of the place. I've even taken up fishing. Sorry, Pat, I'm not being much help to you, am I?
What? Oh, yes, of course. It's just that... Why is it taking so long? We seem to have been here forever.
Oh, come on. Actually, they're moving along quite fast.
Are you sure we're doing the right thing? I've made my kids all sorts of promises. I know I shouldn't have, but they were so unhappy.
Of course you're doing the right thing.
What if all this goes wrong? Andrew's bound to run away again, and this time something might happen to him.
Pat, nothing is going to happen because nothing will go wrong. I am depending on you. I've put a lot of work into this case, Pat, an awful lot. Now, it'll all go for nothing if you lose your cool in there. Do you understand?
Good luck, love. Don't let those bastards get you down. Remember, we're gonna beat them, okay?
Right. Yes, I understand. Well, kids, here we come, eh? Let's go. Thank you for being here, Dr. Miller.
Now, you behave yourselves, please, you two.
Yes, madam.
I would like to see Mr. Fletcher, please.
I'm afraid Mr. Fletcher gave strict instructions not to be disturbed.
Is he alone?
Well, as far as I know, madam.
Well, then I want to see him.
Well, he
said... I don't care. I've driven my children a long way to see their father, and we want to see him.
Well, I'll try, madam, but he was very definite.
Oh, I'm sure he'll understand.
Oh, your wife and children are here to see you, Mr. Fletcher. Oh, yes, right. He said you can go on up.
Oh, thanks. Come on, kids.
Oh, madam, there's a parcel here for Mr. Fletcher, if you wouldn't mind.
Can I carry it, Mum?
Oh, all right, but don't drop it.
Take it.